Hey Jeez, it's JC here, and welcome to episode 5 of Let's Talk, the series where I talk about questions you may have or just topics I want to talk about. And for today's topic, we will be talking about the problems / challenges I face while I make YouTube videos. Now, this video will have some gameplay in the background, so I recommend just sitting down and listening to it as a song almost while this happens. And before we start, please be sure to like that video, and if you enjoyed, please be sure to subscribe for more content. And yeah, besides that, I want to do a quick disclaimer that this video is just a problem I have personally faced, and if you guys have any problems which you have experienced, please make sure to leave them down below, and I'll be interested on the problems that other YouTubers have had as well. Now let's begin. So first off, let me tell you when I started YouTube. So I started YouTube back in 2013 when YouTube started to kick off, and the two things that inspired me were, one was TooManySwift11, who now goes by the name of PleaseStandBy, and also for the fact that YouTube gives you the opportunity to make money. Now with that, I started off my YouTube channel and with the dreams of becoming large one day, which is kind of like the dreams you see all the time, right? Now I could go more in depth into why I started my YouTube channel, but that's for another time. But for now, just keep in mind those two reasons I said of why I started YouTube. So fast forward 5 years from now, and I am here with 250 subscribers who like my content, and throughout the entire span, ever since I started in 2013, I have discovered and made new obstacles that have prevented me from making YouTube videos. And here are some of those problems. For example, I tend to watch YouTube videos or read articles online, and next thing I know, I'm spending the next hour and a half, or maybe all the way to the night, just reading that article or watching that YouTube video about how to grow YouTube channels. Now, funny thing is, most of those videos that say how to start off and become a successful YouTube channel, the number one thing that I recommend is that you actually take the time, sit down, and start recording, because there is no better time than starting off now. Now, another distraction I make for myself is I play video games. Now, but every time I start to play a video game, or even before I start, I go in with the mindset of, alright, this is the game right here, and then let me just try it out for a couple of days, maybe an hour, and if it looks like a pretty good game, I'll record it later on in the future. But next thing I know, I'm playing that game for the entire day, and I make no single video about it, because it is so good. So the final distraction I create for myself is just like to browse the internet. So sometimes I just like to sit down on my bed, or just right here when I'm about to start recording, I look up how to effectively make an intro. Next thing I know, I'm browsing the internet looking at YouTube videos about cats and or Minecraft, and I just get distracted. And maybe I just go to the Hypixel forums and just read those things. And basically, I just don't know how to time manage. Now, I should also mention that school is a distraction, but school, that's a distraction all in itself. And long story short, I personally take priority to my education, so that's why I prefer doing school over other things. Now for the next challenge. Now, another problem I face is the lack of powerful technology I have. So as of now, I currently play on a MacBook Pro 2013 edition, and this thing is not for gaming. This is a Mac. And to be honest, Macs in general are not meant for gaming. If you want a game, you're better off buying a Windows computer, because games in general are dedicated or built around the Windows platform. Now, besides having a slow computer, I also don't have any of the new consoles. But I mean, might as well, I don't have a PS4, I don't have an Xbox, I don't have a brand new spanking sparkling new Nintendo Switch. The only things I have right now are my Nintendo 3DS, the original Nintendo 3DS XL, and my Nintendo Wii U. So to build onto this slow powerful technology idea is that I also have slow internet. What does this mean? I am completely trashing PvP battles, because most of the time I just get outpinged by my enemies. Another downside to having slow internet is that some programs like Nvidia GeForce, they highly recommend you have fast internet, and sadly I do not have that. And sometimes, because of the slow technology I have, that in itself makes problems for me. So, for example, sometimes whenever I finish recording a video, the video, once exported, or even once I'm done recording, the video gets corrupt. And there is no worse feeling than watching all of your hard work and dedication and all that time spent making a video, just to discover that all of that video literally went down. So when somebody is burnt out on content creation, what this means is that they have no ideas to create, and they're just uninspired to make videos in general. And even if they do make ideas, they find it very hard to make those ideas. Sometimes it takes them a month or even a week to make just an idea for one single video. And as we speak, I am currently facing that. Well, maybe not as worse as I was experiencing this 3 months ago, but I am still going to experience it, and I probably might experience it. And if you guys, any YouTubers out there watching this video, have yet to experience this, let me tell you it. You will experience this. And sometimes, if you're a large YouTuber, you just feel forced to record videos. And, well, so most of the time when people feel forced to make videos, these videos are most likely the ones that are underperforming. And there really is no point in making any videos if you're feeling forced and or I cannot. Sometimes I just find it too hard to hit that little core button right there because of fear of being judged, not by you guys because I can obviously edit out, but in fear of being judged by my own family members because the area I am in right now is very open to my family. Not the only reason I'm doing this right now is because I am literally by myself, but I will try to be more open with my family in the vicinity and with them being in the vicinity. Now before I stop here, I should also acknowledge one more problem or issue I have faced while being a YouTuber, and that issue is called personal safety. Sometimes people, they get too close to my real life, and sometimes very, very close to just contacting me. And let me tell you this, YouTube and real life, those two things should never mix. As a YouTuber, you put yourself up there, and the only way to not put yourself out there is to not record. That is the only way to protect yourself from YouTube besides resetting your passwords once a month. And I do not want to sit down and reset passwords once a month. That's a very tedious task. I personally spend 2 days resetting my passwords. I know this because I did this just recently. So those are just some of the challenges I face while being a YouTuber. Now if you're curious about how I solve most of these issues, please be sure to check out next week's video when I solve the solutions to these problems. And if you yourself or have seen somebody else with problems of being a YouTuber, please comment down below and I'll be interested in seeing them and maybe possibly solving them in the next video. And oh boy, YouTube, it's a very difficult thing, but if you're up to it, then kudos to you. So you can stay notified whenever this video comes out by subscribing and following me on Twitter. And if you like this video, please make sure to like, share, and subscribe. I'm PleaseStandBy. I will see you all in the next video. Bye bye.